Succeeds like success, and the Reds have started to build a team that can succeed on a regular basis. But there are other considerations when one comes out to the ballpark, and that's what we'll talk about tonight. We're dealing with the ballpark experience for the fans. What do you like? What would you like to see in the future? Here's how you can be part of tonight's show. Give us a call, 749-9999, or send us an email at soas@wcpo.com. Joining us for the second year in a row is Phil Castellini. His title is Chief Operating Officer of the Cincinnati Reds. According to the media guide, that means he's responsible for all business and ballpark operations for the team. That's very narrow, huh?
It is very narrow. I like to tell people I can't take credit or blame for what happens on the field.
That's right. But outside the field, I guess, falls within your responsibility.
You betcha.
Five years ago, when you came with a group of your people from the front office, part of the discussion was selling a team that wasn't very good, a very mediocre team. Now you're selling a team that's good. Is it a big difference?
Oh, huge difference. On the business side, you know, we need to be prepared to make it the best fan experience we can, regardless of what's happening on the field, and we've certainly worked hard to do that. And everybody at Great American Ballpark, our full-time employees as well as seasonal, every single time that we open the venue, but certainly with the team playing as well as they have over the last couple of years, the wind is at our back relevant to selling the product, and it's definitely a fun time to be a Reds fan and a Reds employee.
Still, I imagine there's checks and balances on that for the fans on the field that you have. Fan could come there and they could see a 5-0 win, but if something goes wrong, they'll still complain.
Yeah, there's no question about it. And so again, any game is somebody's first game, perhaps somebody's last game. It could be a kid's first game. So we try and make the experience as special as possible.
Are you seeing new fans?
We are. Matter of fact, you know, we're seeing more diversity in the ballpark than ever before with Chu in center field, and we've certainly got a big focus on that in the African-American and Spanish-speaking communities as well with the Latinos in town. And so, you know, we're trying to make sure that all Greater Cincinnati and Reds Country fans know that they're welcome at Great American Ballpark, and we're starting to see some fans that we haven't seen for some time.
You talk about Reds Country. When I came here, and I was amazed, you go up into Ohio, you go to West Virginia, Indiana, Kentucky. What is Reds Country now? Is it expanded?
Yeah, well, you know, I think it's expanded in terms of not necessarily geographically, but the numbers of people following in those, you know, far reaches of Reds Country. It's really, you know, something in the neighborhood of 150-mile radius of downtown Cincinnati. But again, as you said, parts of West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, Indiana. And so really it's, you know, towns like Indianapolis and Columbus are certainly towns that we're focused a lot more on. I think over the years, maybe we lost a little interest in Indianapolis to St. Louis, for example. And so we're trying to get some of that traction back. I think Columbus has been a swing state for us and the Indians in terms of fan focused and what the Columbus market's interested in terms of teams. I think when the Indians were hot, that Columbus tended to trend up north.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And now that the Reds are playing better, I think we're seeing a little bit more of the Columbus trend down here to Cincinnati.
When Walt Jocketty was here, it was right after the caravan, and he had been on the outskirts of town and that stuff and saw big crowds everywhere. Does that usually translate, if you see that in February, to what happens now in April and through the season?
Yeah, there's no question about it. I think in general the fans like what we're doing as an organization, what we're trying to do in terms of fan experience. But there's no question the fans follow a winning team. They follow a team worth following.
Sure.
And that's what Walt and the baseball guys have put together under Dusty's leadership, and what Walt and his baseball operations guys are able to do in terms of producing the talent through the system. And so I think there's a lot more to pay attention to. I think people see some depth in the farm system as well as a great productive team at the major league level. So I think there's no question about it. More fans are following, and more fans are coming to the ballpark.
I think one thing, and later in the show we're going to talk to Joel Luckhop, who has written a book about the Reds, and he says one of the great things to see is you could go up to Dayton and see single A. You could go down to Louisville and see triple A. And I have to think, if you've watched a Billy Hamilton develop, or you've watched a Jay Bruce or Joey Votto develop, that also helps you once they make it to the major leagues.
There's no question about it. And the loyalty that we have in those two markets, in Louisville and Dayton, in terms of those minor league teams, is huge. And it does translate into fans down here in Cincinnati, and hopefully more so in the coming years as well.
Okay. A Reds Chief Operating Officer Phil Castellini is our guest tonight. You can talk with Phil by calling 749-9999 or sending an email, soas@wcpo.com. But first, it's time for the Meyer Mind Bender, your chance to win a $50 gift card from Meyer. This week's winner is Karen Kraus, who knew that 40 years ago, the designated hitter was introduced. Ron Bloomberg of the Yankees was the very first DH. Nice job to Karen. Here's tonight's question. My name is Ted Giannoulis, and I became an institution this week in 1965. You know me better by what name? The real name, Ted Giannoulis, 40 years ago made it big. What name do we know him by? If you know, go to WCPO.com, click on sports, then click on the Meyer Mindbender logo, or send your answer on a card to Meyer Mindbender, 9 Sports, 1720 Gilbert, Cincinnati, 45202. That's the Meyer Mindbender. Back with Phil Castellini right after this.